Hi guys, in this video we are going to learn about arrow function in JavaScript. So in the previous video we discussed about the simple function, that how we can return the values, how we can pass the parameters, how we can call the function and then define the function. So all the stuff I explored in the previous video. So if you haven't watched that video, I am just adding the link into the description, so you can explore the whole playlist which we have completed up till now. So there are a lot of videos which are going to be covering a lot of fundamentals of JavaScript, so you can watch those videos as well. But for now, let's start with the arrow function in this video. So first of all, I am going to write here a function. For example, I have fun. This is the name of the function. I am going to return a value 5. So if I am going to call this function, so this is the syntax, like function name and parenthesis. And since I am returning the value, so I need to assign that value into the result variable or any variable you want. And then after, I need to do a console.log. Alright, and inside of it I can write result. Alright. So once you will refresh the page, you will get the output like 5. So one more thing you can do is, like I have assigned the value and then written the console, you can directly call the function from inside of console as well. So now I am going to write here inside, and I am going to remove this statement completely. So if you will see the output, again you will be getting the same output, which is 5. So this is much simpler. So there is another way to define the function as well. For example, I am writing here let fun1 equals to function, and then I have the parenthesis. So here you can return a value like 7. So this is fun1. So I am going to call that function now. So fun, and here is fun1. So if you will refresh the page now, you will get the value 5 and 7. So once you are calling this function fun, then you are returning the value 5, and if fun1 is called, then 7 is returned. So in this way we are going to call the function, and you can see the syntax of both these functions. Actually both are working the same, but the syntax is little different. Here we are just assigning the function into a variable, and that is this variable type is actually function. So if you will see on the console, for example console.log, and here I am writing type of operator, and if you are writing fun1, let's see, so you can see that here is the function. So that means this is not a variable actually, this is a function. So here we just proved that this is a function. So one more thing here is like arrow function. So what is the arrow function here? So the same syntax, for example, let fun2, and then after, for example, I am writing function and then this one, and going to return a value, for example, 10. Alright, so this is the same function which is fun1, but I wanted to convert it into the arrow function. So what I will be doing is, I will be removing this function keyword completely from here, and then I need to add a fat arrow here, and that's it. And if you are yes, of course, so let me print that. So console.log, then I have fun2, and if you are going to refresh the page, you will be getting the output 10. So that means fun2 is returning the value 10. But here what we can do is, for example, we have only single statement, so we need not required these parentheses at all. Alright, so what you can do is, you can remove this one completely, and you can write in a single line only. So here you need not write the return value. So you can see that we have the value 10. Alright, so one more thing you can do here is, like for example, we are going to pass a specific parameter into the function. For example, I am writing here 2 or maybe 4, and that would be received over here. For example, I am writing x, and then I am going to multiply this x with 10, and then once the function would be called, 4 would be passed over here, and then I am going to multiply with 10, so 10 into 4 equal to 40. So let's see on the output screen. So you can see that 40 is printed. Alright, so this way you can pass the parameter. Since we have only a single parameter, we can also remove these parentheses as well. Alright, but here actually I have used the prettier formatter extension in the VS Code, which is actually not allowing me to remove these parentheses. But still, if you wanted to remove these parentheses, this will also work. And if you have more parameters, then you can use the parentheses. You need to use the parentheses as well. For example, I am writing here 3. So 4 comma 3, and that would be received into x and y. For example, I am writing here x and y into 10 into x into y. So that would be giving me the output something like this, 120. So everything has been multiplied now. So for example, I have multiple statements over here, then I need to write here the parenthesis. Alright, so if we have multiple statements, so for example, I am writing here let result equals to this one, and now want it to return the value, so return result. So in this way, the same value would be over here 120, but this time we have used two statements, that's why we have to add these curly braces over here. So this is the way we are using the arrow function, and you have seen that for example, we are only interested in writing a single statement, so you can see the compatibility. I mean, you can see that how compact is this one. For example, I am writing this way. Wait a minute. Yeah, this way. You can see that the same thing is going to be done over here, the same thing is going to be done over here, and same thing is going to be done over here. You can see that these has been completed in three number of lines, but here you have done the same work within a single line. So that's the quality of an arrow function, which is just helping us to reduce number of lines. And this is also a super simple way to use the function wherever we have required. Alright, so I think that you got the basic concept of arrow function, that how this is going to be used and how this is different from other syntaxes, and what is the role of this one. I mean, function is actually the block of code that is going to be reused. The purpose of this function is also the same as that of the other functions, but here the syntax is very much compact. So that's why we are happy to use the arrow function mostly. So thank you so much. See you in the next video. So don't forget to subscribe and like the video.